It's now 2 years since the Chancellor, Sir Geoffrey Howe, first came up with the idea of an enterprise zone in a speech delivered at this site on the Isle of Dogs. 8 out of 11 enterprise zones up and down the country are now open, but it's ironical that this site on the Isle of Dogs should be the last to be fully operational. It should be open by next February. The Isle of Dogs enterprise zone covers 475 acres. The incentives for industry to move to an enterprise zone are considerable. No rates for 10 years, no development land tax, and perhaps the biggest carrot of all, freedom from normal planning restrictions. The manager of London's Enterprise Zone claims that it will bring welcome facilities to the whole of the Isle of Dogs.
Given that we shall be providing new services, providing extension on existing services, providing new estate roads, improving the loop road which serves the island here, this will not just service the zone itself, but it will also service the existing companies who've already made a commitment in this area.
But the zone has its critics. The site centres around the enclosed docks in the middle of the island, and the boundary stops well short of the riverfront, where local industry had begun to establish itself before the zone was announced. Now firms like this shipping company find themselves within a few hundred yards of the perks of the zone, but unable to take advantage of them. They claim the enterprise zone has wasted the opportunity to use the riverfront to rejuvenate the derelict area.
I feel a great opportunity has been lost, so far as the River Thames is concerned, which is an artery into the centre of London, the capital of the UK, where goods could be carried in small ships from Europe, from European cities into London, at a fraction of the energy and fuel cost of a juggernaut lorry.
But this afternoon, plans for the zone took a step forward when the Secretary of State for the Environment, Michael Heseltine, formally invited an application from the Isle of Dogs. He was opening an exhibition designed to attract industry to set up shop in one of the 11 enterprise zones. I asked him if he thought the Isle of Dogs project, one of the smallest, which has taken 2 years so far to reach this preliminary stage, had a real chance of success.
I fully accept the point you make about the time it's taken to get to where we are today, but I think what one has to realise is that in order to do something like this, you have to get legislation through Parliament, you have to have deep consultations with local people, and all of that quite rightly takes time. But we're now past that stage, and I hope we shall be able to make rapid progress.
To date, the Thames area's only enterprise zone has attracted nearly 300 inquiries. Industry and commerce would bring jobs and housing to one of the most derelict areas of London. Jane Corbyn on the Isle of Dogs for Thames News.